Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you're a first time visitor or returning guest, thank you so much for stopping by. Consider subscribing to this channel and liking this video. Today I'm walking you through how to create an image cutout overlay like this right here using Adobe Express. So let's go ahead and dive right in. Here I am at the home screen of the all new Adobe Express, and we're going to start by clicking on the blue plus sign here on the top left corner. I'm going to go ahead and choose landscape for this project here. And what I will do is close this out, and we're going to go to media. And what I want to do is find an image that I can cut out to have a section reveal a video in the background. So I'm going to go ahead and go old school TV here and find an image that will be able to cut out and reveal video in the back. And I think I'm going to go with this old school television here. And what I will do here is resize this. I do not want to choose the option to set to background because I need to be able to move this between layers. And you can also crop, but resizing works as well. We're going to resize it right about there. I want the antenna to still be in view. And what we're going to do next is we are going to remove the background. And what will happen is Adobe Express will remove the entire background from the TV, which is fine. What we're going to do is adjust the crop here a little bit. I want the crop to be covering the entire scene here. So you want to make sure and fix that before we start doing some adjusting. Okay, so we got it cropped. And now what we'll do is go to erase. And what we'll do is choose restore. So now we have the entire project. And what I want to do is restore everything that has been removed. So what we'll do is increase the size and just basically wrap around, and now everything has been restored. And now what we'll do is go to erase, and I'm going to bring that size down. This will vary depending on the image that you choose. So I'm going to go ahead now and click in here with quick selection, and Adobe Express has removed the entire section, but we got a little bit of extra here that has been removed. That's a quick, easy fix. We'll go to restore, and basically we'll just slowly click here. Let's go ahead and increase the size just a tad bit, and we'll just slowly click here to bring everything, or I should say restore everything back to where it was. There we go. We're getting closer and closer. Got a tad bit there. Perfect. Let's just check around. Okay, it looks like we have everything. So what will happen is when I click done, everything will be back to normal, except for this middle section will be deleted. So let's click on done. And what we're seeing through here is the background color. I'm going to go ahead and just show you here. We'll change it. This is a nice practice here just so you can see the background, making sure that you're doing the right job. Okay, so now the next step is to add some video here. What I'm going to do is go to media and choose video, and for this I'm going to go and choose static, and let's see what comes up for static. We got like TV static. Perfect. This is what I need right here. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on that, and it's brought into my scene. I'm going to go ahead and show layer timing, and I'm going to just drag this over the TV screen section, and I'm going to resize this to fit right about the center there. And I can go ahead and crop this here, and we'll just crop it so that we can see the entire, I should say, so it can cover the entire screen here. And we'll just move this around and resize this a little bit. There we go. And we should be just fine. I'll click out here. Perfect. Now, right now, it is on top of that, which is okay. And all you need to do is drag that bottom layer to the top over here on the top right. And now the TV is behind. So if I click play, you'll see that static happening. What I'm going to do next is, let me increase the size here just to get zoomed in a little bit. And I'm going to drag the scene here so that when this starts, we have basically a dark screen. I'll convert that to black here in a second, but what will happen is it'll be black and it'll come into the static. So just stay with me, hang on here, and you'll see where I'm heading to here. Then let's go ahead and do this with this scene here. Let's bring this back down. And what I'm going to do is just not so much crop, but basically only make a certain amount of that visible. So let's see here, we will go to the front, hit play, have a little static. I'm going to have the static just a little bit longer, and then maybe about 1 second. The next step is I'm going to bring in another video. I'm just going to choose one of my videos from my YouTube channel that I've already created. We'll bring that one into scene and it will actually drag into the top here. We're gonna go ahead and resize that. It's gonna be cropped just a tad bit. We're gonna go with the landscape, or I should say the widescreen look, into a little TV. So we'll have some black bars here at the top of the bottom, which is fine. We'll go ahead and do that. I'm gonna go ahead and resize this just a tad bit. And so now we will drag this, or I should say we can drag the TV screen to the top. And now we've got the video and we've got the static here. So let's go ahead and move this bar right up there, because that's where we want the video to appear. And so what I'll do is I'll click the layer of the video and we will drag this, so that way when we click play, static, and boom, the video appears. I'm gonna go ahead and mute my video just so it doesn't play too loud. Let me go ahead also and make a little adjustment to my video. I'm just gonna use my arrow keys, bring this down. And now we'll change the background color to black. There we go. So we've got those bars at the top and the bottom. Perfect. Now, a couple more things and it will be wrapped up here. I'm going to go to audio and I'm going to upload a couple of files that I found on Epidemic Sound. It's a website I use for a lot of sound effects and for background music tracks. I'm going to go ahead and add the TV set on, and that's going to be the TV when it turns on. We're going to drag that to the front, and so I'll hit play. Let's bring this to the front. You may or may not be able to hear this. There we go. So the TV turned on right about there, and then at this point we're going to drag in some static noise, and that is this one right here. Hit play, and I actually don't want that playing throughout the entire video. So I'm going to drag this until about my video comes in, because I have music right about, let's see there. And let me go ahead and zoom in here just to make sure that I get this spot on right about there. Yeah, looks like I did a pretty good job there. So if I hit play, actually let's bring this TV set a little down here and let's drag this here. Oh, there we go. Let's try. There we go. Drag this over here and let's give it a little bit of music right about there. Okay, so if I hit play now, and there my video starts to play there. And I think I actually might want this static to last a little bit longer, maybe about a second. And I will make an adjustment to my video here. All I need to do is drag this right about to, let's see here, we'll drag this to about where the static ends, and also then drag this there. There we go. So I should have this pretty much set. Oh, we had the black screen a little bit too short. Let's go ahead and adjust the static. The static should last about the length right about there. It's a little fine tuning that you'll have to do here. I think I've got this done. Let's go ahead and give it one preview. Perfect. Exactly the way I wanted it to work, cutting out the screen and then having that video effect. I could always make this larger if I want to, but for now, this is working. But a couple other examples, I'm gonna go ahead and share another one that I worked on. This one is actually a phone overlay that I did the same step, and then I just added my video behind it. There's one that I shot with my drone. So basically, use this to promote projects, to promote events, share with your audience, students, or whoever. Have a really nice, cool way to add videos using this image cutout overlay effect. And that's how to create image cutout overlays using Adobe Express. So now it's your turn to give it a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell to be notified for future videos. And please share this video with your friends. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, be good to one another. Have fun creating. Peace.